Rev up your engines. Today I'm going to talk about a car insurance company that you should not buy car insurance from. Now, of course, all car insurance and all insurance companies are out to make a profit. They take your premiums, try to get them as high as they can, then they try to pay out as little as possible to make a profit. Those giant insurance company towers like the AIG one that's three blocks from here didn't get built for free. It wasn't Jack and a Beanstalk. It's your insurance premiums that made them make a lot of money to build those buildings and to pay themselves a lot. And to give you an example of my own personal car insurance, I've been driving for 45 years. Well over $70,000 in car insurance premiums. And over those 45 years, the claims that I put in and got paid for, I'm a good driver, came down to less than $6,000. So do the math. Who came out? The insurance company. They came out like bank robbers. If you take all the other insurance that I've paid in the last 45 years, house insurance, health insurance, and car insurance, you're talking over $240,000 that I've shelled out to insurance companies. I have had claims paid for the house for hurricane damage and health stuff done to me of less than $40,000 total. They made $200,000 off of me. So realize these insurance companies are making a lot of money. Look at all the advertising they do. Hey, they spend hundreds of millions of dollars advertising to try to get you to give them money so they can make more profit. So I'm gonna show you which car company is the worst one that you shouldn't deal with for buying car insurance. And the winner of this competition, or should I say loser, Mafrey. You might not have heard of them, but they insure things often for other companies. Now Mafrey is a Spanish company, so what am I talking about it? Well, they bought a Massachusetts only company called Commerce Insurance. This was in 2008. Then the Commerce joined Mafrey's gigantic worldwide insurance that has more than 50,000 agents. Not making this up, 50,000 insurance agents. Now this particular company serves mainly the New England area in the United States, but worldwide, they're in over 49 countries serving over 35 million people. And at least here in the United States, if you think bigger is better, not in this case. They have so many complaints against them. They have complaints that they kept billing customers even though they canceled the insurance, of keeping jacking up people's rates, even though they haven't been in any accidents, and even not paying for work at a body shop when people had their cars wrecked. They just flat out refused to pay. As a mechanic, I see this happening with many different insurance companies. I remember going to a customer once to a State Farm, and all I heard the agent in his private office, he picked up the phone and said, "Oh, I'm sorry, you're not covered for that. Oh, I'm sorry, you're not covered for that." You know, they want to take in as much as they can and pay out as little as possible and make you jump through hoops half the time to get something that you've already paid for. Now, another company that's notorious for being a poor insurance company used for cars is MetLife. Yeah, they're like the largest life insurance sellers in the United States. MetLife had 2.5 trillion in policies written the last time I checked. Well, of course, like everybody else in big business, they get greedy. Now, of course, they've expanded into car insurance and stuff. And from my customers' experience and others that I've met, they often do a horrible job insuring cars. All right, a customer was quoted $250 a month, which is high enough. And then when they got their bill, it was actually 500 something. And they just said, "Oh, well, we made a mistake when we gave you a quote, so here's what you owe us now." I had another customer with MetLife. They had no accidents for 5 years. They just had their insurance policy raised by 25%. So they called up and said, "You know, what's up? I didn't get any accidents." And they said, "Well, that's the way it is, and we're gonna cancel your policy when it's over because we don't like your attitude." These insurance companies are gigantic to humongous. They can basically do as they please. They take in all the premium money. Of course, it's to their advantage to pay out as little as possible. But in many places, it's law that you have to have car insurance. Now, here in the state of Texas, it isn't law. If you can prove financial responsibility, like if you have more than 200 grand in the bank or something, you can use that as proof of insurance if you want to. But of course, the whole point of the insurance company is they try to scare you and saying that, "Oh, you're safe. You're covered now." While they make a fortune because it's all done mathematically. They can't lose. Whenever something bad happens, then they just raise the rates in the future, like here in Houston. Last time we had a big hurricane, guess what? all the insurance rates went up. And they'd put a disclaimer in every one that would say, oh, the first $20,000 of hurricane damage you have to pay for, that's the deductible only for hurricane damage. So you don't want to use a bad company. It's bad enough that you're giving them a ton of your money when something bad does happen. Hey, you want them to pay for the damage that was done and not raise your rates. But unfortunately, that's how a lot of these companies work. I'll give you my own personal example. I had one car insurance and they made a mistake. And instead of emailing me the bill for the year, they emailed it to my wife. So I didn't see it. I've been with this company for 10 years. Then they dropped me because they said, well, you didn't pay. And I said, well, I didn't get a bill. They get one in the mail and they said, oh, we only do it online now. I said, well, who'd you mail it to? And they mailed it to my wife's email. I said, I'm the one paying it. It's my email. You should have mailed it to me. So they dropped me. Then I went all over the place trying to buy insurance and they said, oh, well, you had a lapse in coverage and now we want $4,500 a year instead of the $900 that I was paying. So I finally got Liberty Mutual. They decided they were gonna give me a policy and it was more than I'd been paying before. It was like $1,200 a year and before I was paying less than $1,000, but I had no accidents the year I was with them. And then the next year they raised to 25%. For no reason whatsoever. But then, hilariously enough, like I said, these giant corporations, one side doesn't know what the other's doing. My original companies that dropped me because they said I had a lapse in coverage and they wouldn't cover me, they kept sending me a little credit card thing that says, oh, we'll give you a good deal. So I went back to them and got the price that I had in the original place. From the company that said they didn't want to insure me anymore, then they kept sending me things to say, oh, we want to insure you. It's patently absurd the way these companies operate. Now, I'm sure a lot of people out there have problems with their insurance companies too. I'll give an honorable mention to Farmers. They're a pretty crummy insurance company. I've had customers have problems getting claims paid from them and then having their rates jacked up if they get in a little fender bender. A lot of them, they just don't care about you. But at least now you know two of them that you should stay away from. And when you're in the market for buying insurance, ask your friends what experiences they have. Just don't go out and buy it on a whim because you don't want to be stuck with one of these crappy companies that when you do get in a pinch and something happens, they make you go through a whole rigmarole to get for something that you've already paid for. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.